sumubok sa ating mga balitang maritima.
Samantala, update tungkol sa crew change protocols, makakasama natin si Marina Administrator Robert Empedrad. Magandang gabi, Vice Admiral Empedrad.
Good evening, Lynn, at sa lahat ng mga nanonood sa Marina World Weekend. Thank you for inviting me in this episode.
Ano po ang pinakabago sa protocols na ipinatutupad natin sa crew change dito sa ating bansa?
Lynn, sa ngayon, we still pinatutupad pa rin natin yung green lanes, yung green lane protocol natin. It's a joint protocol. And alam nyo naman na pabago-bago yung ating protocol depending on the threat of the coronavirus. Just recently, when we found out there is a new strain variant, and we flagged down countries that were affected. Pero ngayon ay yung restriction ng red flag countries has already been lifted. So parang bumalik tayo sa dating normal crew change na ginagawa. But there are some amendments sa crew change. Like for example, yung mandatory na ngayon yung quarantine. So when the seafarers arrive, they have to undergo quarantine. Then on the sixth day, they will be tested if they have the virus or not. If they are tested negative, they will be allowed to go home. But upon arrival sa LGU sila, sa residence nila, not in the residence but in their LGUs, they will have to complete the remaining days of their 14-day quarantine before they will be allowed to go home to their respective families. So yun yung pagkaiba. And all ports identified as crew change are now again allowed to conduct crew change from the red flag countries. The quarantine facility will be provided by the OWA for as long as the request for the facility is made in advance.
Sir, kailan naging effective yung lifting ng dun sa mga red flag countries?
I'm not, I don't have the right date kung kailan na-lift. Pero ngayon, as we speak today, wala na tayong red flag countries na sinasabi.
But definitely naapektuhan yung crew change natin. So yung deployment ng ating mga seafarers, no? Yung kasagsagan ng paglitaw ng UK variant.
Oh, yes, key variant. Yes, of course. Especially nung nalaman nila, meron daw nakapasok sa atin. So, we have to be very strict. And I think maganda yung ginawa natin. Baka sana nagawa natin ng paraan na hindi dumami yung variant, yung strain variant na pumasok sa ating bansa. So, I think in a way, we were very successful in addressing the second the strain variant that is coming from the red flag countries.
But of course, effective pa rin, yung one-stop shop, yung pa rin ang ating
one-stop shop. Still the one-stop shop is doing the crew change, the testing is there, all the agencies are lumped into one place para mapabilis yung movement ng ating mga seafarers pagdating sa Pilipinas at pag sila i-employ sa bago nilang destination.
So ano po ang assurance na may bibigay natin sa ating mga seafarers, ship owners, at maritime stakeholders?
We will assure everyone that we will continue to inform our LMAs, our ship owners, the seafarers, if there are changes in the protocols. And our assurance is kaya naman namin ginagawa ito para ma-assure na yung ating mga seafarers will not be infected by the coronavirus. So, ang inyong health protection ang number one priority ng bakit sometimes ay nagbabago yung protocol natin, depende sa threat ng coronavirus. But we will continue to update you and we will inform you as soon as possible when there are changes in the policy or in the crew change protocol.